Hello students, this is Kanta Mangwani and today we are starting chapter 12, that is using IO operation, that is input and output. Before starting, please subscribe my channel, hit bell icon and like. So let's begin. Now introduction, all programming languages allow read input, whatever say input we are giving from keyboard and mouse, that they are reading. Okay, that is a known as a input operation, and to write output is known as a output operations. Very simple. Okay, now input means read data from keyboard or mouse, that I already told you. Now output means to write the data from output devices like monitor and printer, etc. Input and output operation is known as a input and output operations. Okay, IO operations. C not have built-in statement to perform input and output operations. Be remember that. So all the command we will give from the program only. So data input and output operation carried in standard input output built-in library function. Some input and output operations carried out by the standard libraries, that is input output libraries given by the C. So let's check again new. Use of scanf as the standard input and printf as in standard output function. Okay, so in this chapter we learn IO operation using, say, first is get character, second is get ch, and third is gets, then scanf, printf, put character, put c, that is also character, but some difference is between that. So eighth is puts. So let's start again. Now variable to use process data in program. We use the variable actually to process the data that we have already discussed in previous chapters, that what is variable. Okay, now two way to use input variable, two way, that one is used for assignment operator, that for example number equivalent to say 5, okay, semicolon. Now second is read from the user during the execution of the program. Whenever you run the program, it will ask you about, say, suppose radius, circumferences, or say some names that in a execution it will ask you. Okay, inbuilt input functions. What is inbuilt input function? C provides inbuilt input functions that are stored in a C library, that we already know that some standard input output operations using by C libraries. So to use any inbuilt input function from C library, we have to use include library function in the beginning of the program, that is a hashtag include, and statement is that hashtag include and then angular bracket standard input output dot h and angular bracket close. Now name standard io dot h stand for standard input output header. Okay, very simple. Now header file contains io operation of the function. This header file contain IO operations. Okay, hashtag include performs compiler to find the standard input output, that is standard IO dot h file and place of contents of the program. It will place your contain in the compiler and it will, you know, scan it actually. Okay, now contain of the header file then become part of the program. So contain of the header file is a actually part of the program. First is get character. Simplest way to read the character from the C program at the runtime. Okay, runtime. Okay, so use the get character function. So variable name underscore, that we have to give, and equivalent to get character and small brackets we will do. Okay, now variable name, any valid C variable with the name of character as data type. Actually, now just right we are doing the data type is a character actually. Now, get character has no parameters. Okay, this has no parameters because some result we will put here actually, state name or say yes or no something. Okay, it reads a single character, say input, say yes, no, male, female, or something else actually. Now, function written as int, that is ASCII code relevant character. Okay, we will use int actually, so we derive the get character. We can assign the input given by the user to a character variable. We will assign the when we execute the program, we will assign the character in the program actually. So program of this function on the workbook page, let's check. Now here it is a Scintilla text editor and example of get character function. Now here include standard input output libraries dot h, and now here already given int main. Okay, now curly bracket start, character answer. What is our declaration? Character is answer. Now print, then bracket, quote, then would you like to study, say question mark, then backslash n, quote over, then semicolon, then printf, quote, enter yes for yes, capital, because single character is always written in a single quote. Okay, now and single quote n for no. So here you give the input to the program that yes or no. Okay, now answer is get character. What is your answer? It is get character. So if the answer is equivalent to yes, if the answer is equivalent to yes, say double equivalent to sign is for equivalent checking. Okay, then answer double equivalent to y. So print f, that is a output and input both the statement actually, go to study room. If your answer is would you like to study, yes, so go to study room. Else if it is not satisfied this statement, then else print f quote go to playground. Okay, and return value 0. Program ends. Now here is the output of previous slide actually. So here it is asking you when execution of the program. So enter Y capital, that is a yes, N for no. So here the person have given input as a Y. So when it is watching that that program Y, so it will give you the output is go to study room. Now get ch, see the function of get ch read the, a character from the user. We will put the some character actually. Okay, so the user will put the character in the program. The difference between get character and get ch, that character keyed will not echoed on the screen. See, this is a different between, because you give the character in the execution of the program. This is not happen in this. Okay, so it will not echoed in the screen. Okay, directly it will check in the program. So the character entered by the user not visible on the screen. Very simple. Okay, now use the function in previous slide. The program, we observe the difference between function. Now get c, now this is another getting character from the program. Get character, get ch and get c are the single character. Be remember all having MCQs. So be remember that single character used in a get character, get ch and get c. Okay, so but difference between get c reads character from a file instead of standard input device. Okay, that is already inbuilt in the program, so we will not give while execution of the program that input device read from the while going the running program. Execution of the program, it will already given from the keyboard in the program, written in the program actually. Now gates, see gates some having string actually. Different libraries function like gate character, gate ch and gate c, read only character at a time, single character. It means say y n, yes no, something like that. Okay, so to read the two characters can call gate character function two times. If you want to give the second character as an option, so you have to run program again. Very simple. If you that previous program, if we say the no, then you have to again run the program. So what happened? So calling character not good for logic when want to read group of characters. So it is a string actually. So how can we derive the group of character like Gujarat, say my state name is Gujarat, something like that. So call a group character as a string. So what syntax we will use? Say, so gates variable name, we will close this one. So gates function one string, a variable as an argument. It is like an argument actually. So that is inbuilt while the declared variable is written in between these brackets. Now variable name is a character array. Somehow sometime it is an array also, otherwise you can directly put the variable name actually. Now gates, when execution of the program gates is encountered, program wait for the user to enter characters from input. Okay, that already given in the program, that user has given already by from the input. So what happened? Function read the character until new line character entered by the user. So what it will do by the program, then new line will be entered only when the user will entering the some characters, and afterwards then appends the null character, that is a backslash zero end of the string. Always remember that, say string is terminated by null character by say backslash zero, so it is a termination actually. So after execution of the function character and null value ends the all character stored the declared variable name. So what will happen if you given in a single quote some Gujarat, say some name, say then it will stored in a say character, and also a null value is given at the end, so it will store in a variable name. So program of this function on the next slide. Now here it is a gates program actually. So include libraries standard input output dot h int, then starting curly bracket, and here it is given character state name, and we have given array. So it means that our state name is about to 30 characters, right? Now printf, what is your state name and question mark and backslash n and quote. This statement is a output statement is given actually, and in a it will ask you when while running, so what you want. So gates, that in brackets the same state name should be written here. Now afterwards the printf, your state name is percentage s for string, okay, then backslash n, and here you will write the same variable name state name, then return zero end of the program. Now here you check that while you have execute this program, what is your state name, it is asked by the computer or program from you. So you have written Gujarat, so answer will come your state name is Gujarat. Formatted input. See, many situation program where use the input function is not useful. Whatever input function is given to computer, some multiple data types actually. So what we will do? Okay, that formatted input is there. All character read the function, read only character as a time. See, like that we run the program, it will read from the program. Then say gets is a read multiple characters until user press enter. Suppose some character we will write, then after some you press the enter, then if you want to input data like this one, so 33 Mundra Ahmedabad, so what first part of data is roll number 33, second and this part of the data are the name of the city. Okay, so the roll number is integer data type and remaining two. Okay, two are the character data type. Now formatted input, again C provide facility to call formatted input function using read data such type. Okay, that numerical and alphabetical both. So we use the formatted input is scanf, that is a scan formatted. Now scan formatted, the two brackets will come, so in between that we will write the command. Stand for scan formatted. Scan formatted allows to input data into a particular data format like int, character, float, etc. So syntax for scanf, that is scanf, then bracket, then quote, then control string, whatever your data type you want to derive, the control string specify the data format which refer to the values are to be stored. So %LF, double float. Okay, if it is capital, then it is a long double float. Now after this quote is over, this is a control string, then comma, then variable 1, 2 to the n number of variable. So the variable 1, 2, variable n, names of the variable, say and radius, and first, and is a modulo operand actually. Now scanf again, and sign is as a address of the operator in C. So before every variable you want to read from the program, you have to put and sign, and character, and radius, and something like that. So each and every, it is a operator, modulo operator, and specifies the memory location. Okay, memory location. So variable name, roll number, that is a value 33, and memory address, that 2345. Okay, so roll number having value of 33 and memory address is say 2345. What we have to get from that? Say variable name is roll number and value is 33. Okay, but the actual value of the variable stored at the memory address, that is 2345. For example, this is example. Say 33 is stored in a memory address 2345. It is a computer's choice that where it is storing the variable. So in C, variable identifies by its name as well as memory address. So it will find the name of the 33 where you have to store, where it will be stored. So C will identify. C compiler uses memory address for processing, whereas refers to the memory location by name in the program. Whatever name is given, that it is a program's choice, so it will use the memory address by processing and also refer that for memory location by the name of the program. Okay, whatever name you have given, that say 33 Mundra Ahmedabad, like so. That is actually a variable address and that refers to the name. So the control string is known as a format string. Control string is known as a format string, that is a percentage long float. So, that is a given. Help the compiler to interpret the data input given by the user. Whatever data given to the compiler, that interprets the data by the user. So the control string specify the order which variable values appear in the input. So in a control string, suppose 3-4 data is there, say percentage D, percentage F, percentage LF in a line, say in a queue. So each and every will be appear as a input in the control string. So control string format must be processed by percentage sign. A character specify data type. So percentage C for character, percentage S for string, percentage D for integer, okay, something like that. Now reading integers. So for this reading integers, we will use the percentage D actually. The following segment used to read the three integers values from users, say which are stored in mark 1, mark 2 and mark 3 variable. These are three variables actually. So how you will write the declaration statement, that is the int mark 1, 2 and 3, then scanf for input. So bracket quote and percentage d three times, because three integers are there. So 3 percentage d should be given. Okay, then comma and marks 1 and marks 2 and n marks 3. So marks 1 is stored in a first one, marks 2 is stored in a second one, and marks 3 is stored in a third one. Suppose we enter 70, 80 and 90, then 70 will stored in a marks 1, 80 stored in a marks 2, 90 stored in a marks 3. So we can also specify the field width of the number along with the percentage D as under, that is given on the next slide actually. Now scanf for this field width, percentage D, so your width is 2 actually, and then percentage 4D. So marks 1 is stored in a 2D percentage and marks 2 is stored in a 4D percentage. Suppose some example is given here. Suppose we enter 70, 1, 2, 3, 4. Then what happen? Then 70 is stored in a marks 1, but in a 1, 2, 3, 4 in marks 2 variable. Okay, this will stored in this one and this will stored, because this is a 4 marks, this is a 2 marks. Okay, so if we enter 1, 2, 3, 4 and 70, then what will happen? So value 1, 2 is stored in a, say this one, marks 1, and assigned value, because 12 is a field width, percentage 2D. Okay, now 3, 4 will be assigned to the 4D. Okay, the value to the marks 2 actually. Then remain is unused, that is a garbage value. Now reading real numbers. Real numbers, you know that it is comes in a decimal, fractional part. Okay, to read real numbers, float point numbers, percentage of a student in program. So here is some syntax of the real numbers. Float, that percentage F we will use, percentage 1 and percentage 2. So what you will write? Say scanf, then bracket quote, percentage F and percentage F, because two variable we have declared. So quote over, then comma, then percentage 1 and then percentage 2, semicolon, syntax over. Now what will happen? Above define two float, percentage 1 and percentage 2. Scanf statement store float value in these variables. Okay, now if users enter 85.25, then 90.65, then what will happen? 85.25 stored in a percentage 1. Okay, then what will happen? The second one, 90.65 in a percentage 2. So scanf reads real numbers percentage F as a data type. For double float, we will use the percentage LF, small l for double float. Reading character and words. Read a character or a character string using inbuilt. We use function like get character and gets, that we have seen in a previous slide. Many times reading characters or say words using can possible with scanf function, that is a scanf formatted with the percentage C or say percentage S. Okay, percentage C for character and percentage S for say string. String is, it means that it is a group of character and sentence. So here it is a example of that. Character C1 and C2, that is a declared, and here character city, that is given second example, 20. So your city name is in between the character of 20, because it is given array You know that in a square bracket you will give the array. Now scanf, %c and %s. So those three declared variable are there that will be used. So scanf will give an AND modulo sign, %c1, then %c2 and city. Okay, three values are given. But here you check the control string, %c for c1, %c for c2 and %s for city, because city is multiple characters. Now if we enter AB Gandhinagar, then A is stored in a c1, B is stored in a c2 and Gandhinagar is stored in a, say, character array named city. While reading using scanf statement, and ampersand not required with the variable name. Okay, so how can it possible? Because let's check. Remember, %s specification terminates reading when blank space encountered in a input. Okay, now this is say how can we apply in the program that blank space terminate the, say, string actually. Okay, so character city 20 we have given, and scanf %s as a control string given, and here we have written same variable city here. Now if we enter New Delhi, and when we new is stored in a, say, variable city, then Delhi is ignored, because the it will read the only New Delhi, space will be terminated, so Delhi will be not shown as a, in a output actually, ignored by the scanf %s specification terminates reading space after New Delhi. So here we have to define somewhere another, say, string actually, because we have given single s actually, so Delhi will be ignored. Now restricted user input with %square bracket character and %caret sign character. So what it is both the denoted, let's see. C provide facility of percentage that square bracket characters used to specify the permissible character in the input string. This is a program on the next slide actually. If user input string contains any character not in a listed in percentage, say, given in the character, suppose you are writing in the small ABCD, you are writing capital ABCD, so it will not encounter in between that output will not come. So specification, then string terminated at the first occurrence such characters. Program for this function on the next slide. Here given %character in a square bracket, let's check here, include, say, same int main, character student name, so student name size is a 30, printf small bracket quote, then enter your name containing only alphabet and space. Okay, so it is the next line, then scanf small alphabet and capital alphabet and quote over. Now comma student name, that same variable given here. Now printf quote, your name stored in a variable is %s, because it is a group of name, so group of alphabet actually, so %s is used, backslash and then quote over comma student name. Now return value 0, end of the program. Let's check the output of this program. Now here it is given. It will ask you some, enter the name only alphabet and space. Okay, so you have entered Raghi Bharat Patel. Okay, one space in between that. So your name stored in a variable as Raghi Bharat Patel. So enter your name. Now see, another you have to run this program again and input the another name that is a different from this alphabet. So user have entered, say, Raghi B dot Patel. Okay, so when dot encountered with the that square bracket given range, small alphabet and capital alphabet, special character is not used that. So your name stored in a variable is Raggi B, and after this dot that string is terminated. Now explanation of this previous program, actually in previous program specification, that percentage square bracket small alphabet and capital alphabet in scanf specifies that a to z small and a to z capital are accepted only and stored in a variable name, student name. So first education full name of the student is stored in a first time, but during the second education user input contains dot, that is a full stop, so which is not listed in a this control string. So into specification only Raggi B is stored in a variable. So using percentage, then square bracket, caret and characters, that is a control string specification in scanf, that process value inputting immediately when character from the list in the encountered. So if you put some say special character and give the computer command that exit the program, say I will press the star, you will exit the program. So program on the next slide. Here is a program, say percentage, then square bracket, caret and then characters. So how it will work, so let's include library int main curly bracket. So here say character user data, it is 100 given. Okay, printf enter your details. So you will write enter the detail, and that is every time you have to press enter, it will be written till, then printf enter star to exit. You have given that if you press the star from the keyboard, program will be ends or say exit. So scanf, now here star will be scanf, here it is given character we have given. So scanf quote percentage, then caret sign star, then quote over comma, then user data, whatever data you are putting in the while during the running program, execution of the program. Now printf your detail stored in a variable, say backslash n percentage s, s for string, then quote over comma, then user data, here it is user. Now return 0 and ends of the program. Let's check the output. Enter your details. So and next line is given, enter star to exit. My name is this one, my mother's name is this one. Your detail stored in a say variable is my name is Purva and my mother's name is Krina. How it is happen, say after the mother name user has pressed star. So when star is encounter, variable will store the whole string and give you the output. So during the execution of the input, any character including new line, when star is detected by the input string, process input string stopped. Reading mix data. To read different types of data like integer, float, character, string using a single scanf statement. Okay, in this the input data items must be matched with the control string specification of the scanf statement or say scanf syntax in order. And data types, actually both should be same. So example here given, int roll number, character, say character is given grade, then name is 30. Here four types of data types is given. So let's check one by one. Percentage D is used for roll number, and percentage F is used for say percent, and percentage S used for name, actually string, and percentage C for character, that is for grade. So here we will use the modulo sign, say roll number for percentage D here, and percent is given for fractional part, that is a percentage F, and name is a string, and grade is a percentage C character, each and every given in a control string. During the execution of the input specified, suppose 11.90.55 Vani A. This is actually example. Actually, 11 stored in a roll number, and 90.55 in a percent, and Vani in the name, and A in the grade. So four type of data type is given. So if we put 11 Vani A 90.55, then system give error. Be remember, because control string is not matching with the sequence of the data type. Okay, so because user had entered, because user had entered wrong character, not match with the compiler. So compiler is very smart, huh? So it will say reading the data as per the control string only. So list of character which scanf control string read different type of data type on the next slide. See, here it is a list of data type and corresponding character. So reading decimal integers, say 0 to 9, that is a percentage D. So for reading a character, it is percentage C. Now for reading floating point value, that is percentage F and percentage exponent and percentage G. This is also having, say, using for floating point percentage G. We remember MCQ is there. Both. Now for reading string, percentage S. For reading unsigned integer, percentage U. For reading short integer, that is a percentage H. All having MCQs, be remember. For reading a long integer, that is a percentage LD. For reading the double, so say percentage LF. For reading long double, that capital L is used with the LF and also LD. Inbuilt output functions. Three basic function tasks are there in the C program. First is input, process, and output. The inbuilt output function to display process data. When you execute the program, run the program, then Alt F5, it will give you the output. The inbuilt output function available in a, say, standard input output libraries, that is standard io.h. Now, for example, put character, puts, and printf. These are the inbuilt output functions. Now, first is a put character. So, put character is used to write a single character in a standard output device. Okay, so for syntax, put character, then character over here. So here it is a some program of this one. So int main and a curly bracket, character grade. Grade is always a single character. Now printf, enter your grade, then backslash n, then grade is a gate character. So here you will give the reads the single character from the user. Now it will ask you print F, your grade is this, this, this. Now put character grade. Here you have declared grade. So put here grade. Print F, then dot next slide. So return value 0. So the output is, here it is output. So enter your grade. So we have say obtain A grade. So your grade is say A. Now put brackets function has one limitation. It displays the single characters at a time because grade is always a single actually. So to display the multiple character at a time, we have to use loop in the C. Now loop having a separate chapter actually. For that we use puts. Instead of put character, we will use puts, that is a put string in a multiple character. Check the next. Now puts. Puts used for multiple character string or character array on an output. Syntax is that puts then variable name. Variable name is the character array or string, right? So puts function contain stored into variable name till the null character accounted to the end puts. Actually null character should be given. So function not display this character on the screen. Null character is not displayed on the screen. Program on next slide. Program reads multiple character at a time gates, then function stored state variable using, then puts function value stored in a say state variable is displayed on the screen. So you will check the program actually on next slide. Now here it is a puts program actually. So how can we put the our input in the output actually? So integer, then curly bracket, character state 20, this is array. Now enter your state name, then gates state. Here same two input output commands are used. First is gates, then puts. So printf, say your state name is dash, then after this statement it will put state name. So return value 0, end of the program. Now what is the output? Let's check. Now formatted output. See, the output function give output without any formatting. Okay, this is a very simple, whatever output is given by the C, that is a totally say without formatting. Okay, a value stored in variable simply displayed on the screen. Many times prepare reports want to display output with formatting too good and easy to understand like that. So what will happen? Printf function provides use to output with different type of formatting. So this formatting we will use, that we have done actually percentage 2D and 4D, that left and right alignment. Let's check. Now printf, the printf function is used to display formatted output on the screen, right? Now the syntax for this printf, then control string, then each and every variable written in the syntax. Now variable 1, 2 and n is used for variable or constant expressions. Okay, variable and constant both are say expression used. So the output format specification of the variable given in the control string. Okay, that we have to give this in a control string. Now control string contains some of the following item. Say first is a set of character, that is a string, and printed on the appear on the monitor. How will it appear on the monitor? Just check. So for using this one, so escape the sequence. So we use a backslash n, that is a new line, then backslash t for tab, that is a available key in on the keyboard, then back space for say backslash b, like etc. Now printf control string and variables. So control string entry separated by space and also preceded by percentage. Okay, each and every percentage d, percentage f, you have to use that. So later printf contain list of variable values to print. Okay, variable must be match in the number, order and types with format specified given in control string, that I already told in a previous slides. Printf say hello world, say printf your age is percentage d. Okay, then you have to specify the variable. Then printf your name is percentage s, for because name having so much alphabets or characters. Display formatted output with different types of alignment we use format specification in control string. Here is example, percentage i dot m space p. So everything is denoting something actually. Okay, so here I is an integer number specifying the total character position in the which the variable value to print, that left, right, center, whatever. Okay, m is used for specifying number of digit after decimal. Okay, this is used for decimal numbers. I for integer. Okay, so real number or number of character to print string value. Here you will give t, 4, whatever. So p shows each and every having I for integer, m for decimal number real float, and p for showing type of variable. So each and every having MCQ, so be remember that. So P shows the type of variable and list of different data types with printf. Now data type and corresponding character. So here it is a for decimal integer percentage d, character percentage c, floating point value without exponent percentage f, and with floating point percentage e, it means exponent form. So printing string percentage s, unsigned integer percentage u, long decimal integer the percentage ld, a double actually percentage lf, that is a float, long double percentage capital L float, that f, then putting integer octal form, so percentage o octal, then hexadecimal form, so we have to use percentage x, each and every having MCQs. Now here is some example of various format of printf, how it is used. Here it is given output and here it is given program. Now start with include standard io dot h, then int main curly bracket integer number 1 2 3 4, simply here is a print statements, and here we are using various format of printf, and here percentage d and number, so number will variable, so we will include in each printf statement. Here is a percentage 8d, then percentage say minus 8d, that is for left alignment, and all the plus sign say positive numbers are in a right alignment, and last one is percentage 08d actually. So each and every statement having different output actually. So let's check output here. So first is a very simple, as shown percentage d normal, so it will come, then it is a 8d, it will leave the space of 8 spaces, then minus 8d, it should be come in a left align actually, minus d is for left alignment. So plus 2d is leaving the 2 space, then write the number, and last one is that say 0d, so it will leave the space of say 4 spaces, 4 zeros is given, so then write the number. So this is the output of control string percentage d and percentage 2d, etc. Now we have done about only percentage d actually for integer. Now here we use the floating points, so floating point we use the percentage f, so we use percentage I dot m p, where m indicates the number of digit to display after the decimal point. Okay, so float variable display rounded say m decimal numbers, be remember that. So and printed write justified width of one column by default 6 digit display on the places of decimal point, and next slide shows the values different formatting of printf using float. Now here is some example given, say percentage f, simply it is giving you the output, and then say percentage 8 dot 3f, so only 3 decimal number will come. Okay, then 8, so it leaves say a few space, then here given lf, so only one number has came. Okay, floating point, here it is left the say space actually because of 8. Now 08, so it will put the some zeros before the number and give you the output, and after minus it is actually in left align for minus, so minus is given for 4 5 instead of it is rounded by 5, each is rounded actually. Okay, now next one is that percentage 10 3 exponent, so here it is shown the output 1.235 exponent, then plus, now 10 4e, then what will happen, this place is come here, then 4 exponent will show, then 0 2, this actually appear in a say calculator actually. Now modifying the data types string actually. Now we have used percentage d, percentage f, now percentage s, string. So Gujarat, India. Simple, if we say string Gujarat, India will write. Now percentage 8s. So same will be written here. Now 16s. It leave the some space, then it write the say left margin Gujarat, India. So next is a 16.7s. So it will leave so much space before the Gujarat, and India will be garbage value. Okay, now percentage then 7s. So only the Gujarat will come and India will not come. Now say percentage 26.9. So only Gujarat will come, then space I will come. It is given 9s. Okay, so here again printf 26.15. So Gujarat, India whole come, but here leave the space for the number of control string. Students, here chapter 12 is over, and hope you like this. Any feedback, any queries, please message me, contact me, or say give feedback, give comment on the YouTube. Okay, so thanks for watching. Thank you so much.